So I am new to clinical research, and I've heard a lot about these certificates. Do I need a certificate in clinical trials? We're going to answer that question right after the intro. Hey guys, ECRG here, back with another episode. Today we're going to be talking about one of the questions we got from one of our subscribers. So if you're not already subscribed, and you're listening to this video right now, go ahead and subscribe, whether you're listening to the podcast or watching on YouTube. Go ahead and subscribe right now. So one of our subscribers emailed in at eliteclinicalgroup@gmail.com a question. And I'm going to read the email she sent in right here so you guys can get a gist. She said, "I am writing to you with some questions about how to start my career path in clinical research. I have watched a few of your YouTube videos, and I must admit, they are really helpful. I just graduated medical university in Poland as a Master of Laboratory Diagnostics in Health Science. I would like to work in clinical research somewhere abroad, and currently I am looking for some postgraduate courses where I'd be able to obtain their certificate. My question is if you think this would help me to find first job, and if you know any good universities, schools, where I would be able to get the certificate. I have seen most of them provided online through online studying, but maybe you know any universities that provide the classes on campus. The country isn't really the problem. I would be grateful for any tips." So obviously, I love these type of questions because I love the fact that we have an international audience now. That's awesome. So we're getting questions from all over the world. A lot of people are interested in clinical trials and clinical research. That's awesome. So thank you to this person, I'm not going to mention their name, for your question. And so let's go ahead and get right into it. Yes, there are opportunities out there to get clinical trial certificates, but do I recommend them to someone without any experience? The answer is no. I feel like they are very, very useful to people with experience. You've got the CCRP, which is the main one I would recommend. It's very difficult. In order to be able to sit for it, it takes at least 2 years of experience, but oftentimes many, many more. There are people with many, many years of experience who take that certification and still don't pass. So it's very difficult, and that's the one I do recommend. The other ones are kind of by outside organizations, a little sketchy because, you know, they might just be trying to make some money or something, but they are out there. And of course, it's not going to hurt your resume by having a certificate on it, especially if you're new to clinical research, have no experience. It's not going to hurt. But if you're somebody who doesn't necessarily have a lot of money, a lot of dollars, I don't recommend you getting it, because that having certifications, having that book knowledge is not what they really care about. They care about experience. Do you have previous experience? Now, why do sponsors and CROs care so much about experience? The only reason why they care about it is because that's what the sponsors want. The sponsors dictate the industry. Don't forget, CROs, even though they're big and make billions of dollars, they're just glorified vendors of the sponsors. They're just literally a vendor. The sponsor hires them to run the clinical trial. So anything the sponsor does or wants, the CRO is going to do. They're going to follow suit. So I think a lot of people get that confused, but the reason why they want 2 years experience to become a CRA, or if they want experienced people to be in those entry-level jobs or to be in any job when you're working on a study, is because that's what the sponsor wants. The sponsor seems to think that the more experience you have, you know, the better and less money the clinical trial is going to be. And, you know, that might be the case sometimes, but they're beginning to think that competency is more important than the actual number of years of experience. But we're not going to go down that rabbit hole in this video. But basically, the reason why experience is needed over the certifications is because the sponsors want it, and the sponsors really dictate that. So one, you're based in Poland. I'm not too versed on how clinical trials works in Poland. I mean, the opportunities in Poland or the EU or the rest of the world for that matter, other than America and Canada, other than the North American regions. But I imagine that there's more opportunity in America because clinical trials, clinical research is big business, and they hire a lot of people. Top three markets are going to be Raleigh-Durham area, Boston in the Northeast. You got New Jersey, Pennsylvania, and Boston. You've got a lot of sponsors there. And you got San Diego, LA. Those are top three markets in America for clinical trials. So I would definitely look there if you're trying to come to America. And you know, those are probably you're gonna be your best bets if you're trying to get in the industry. But I know there are clinical trials run everywhere. I've worked with people in Mexico before. I've worked with people in South America before, Brazil, Sao Paulo. I've worked with people that are based in Great Britain also before, and Amsterdam. So you've got people all over the world doing entry-level jobs in clinical research, whether they're project specialists, project coordinator, CRAs, clinical trial assistants. They do have positions all over the world. So you can look for those type of positions and understand that those opportunities are out there for you. It just so happens that most of the bandwidth on the internet is coming from America. You've got myself, you've got Dan, shout out Dan at the Clinical Trials Guru, and you've got a couple of the other channels that are coming up now, but the main players on YouTube and the internet seem to be coming out of America, so it makes you think that America has all of the clinical trial experience and all of the clinical trial opportunity. And they do, and we do have a lot of opportunity in America, but they do have clinical trials all over the world. And in fact, these CROs are in fact trying to expand their presence all over the world too. So you can take that for an opportunity to kind of get your foot in the door in a CRO. So there's that. Now when it comes to universities that offer programs or certifications, yes, they are starting to offer more and more certifications. I recently had a client who came in for a resume review who emailed me at eliteclinicalgroup@gmail.com. We worked through his resume together. He was very, very happy with the outcome. And you know, things seemed to work out. And he was applying for a program at one of the top universities. I'm not going to say which one yet because he's in this application cycle, and I don't want a flood of people applying for it, making it harder for him when he's the one who told me about it. So I'm not going to say which university it is, but it is a big time university. So check your big universities, ones that have hospitals, for programs. This program in particular is going to make you into a study coordinator, and they're going to, by the time you're done with it, you're going to be like a pretty high level study coordinator. And it's, I believe it was 2 years if I remember correctly. So they do have programs out there where they teach you, they give you experience, and it seems very thorough. And we actually did a resume specifically for that. And we also did a little essay we had to write for that. We did that one together also. So if you're interested in anything like that, we can help with your resume and any kind of application process issues or any questions you may have. You can email us to get more information on that. But these programs are popping up around the country. I imagine they're going to be abroad at some point also, but they are popping up. And you know, they do have those opportunities for you that you will get a certificate. And I believe in that program also, you get a CCRP, you get to sit for that exam. So it seems like a pretty intense program. And you know, I will let you guys know eventually about it. I did do a review video on it, but that's gonna be coming out way later because I want him to get an opportunity to apply for it, like I said, before I release it. But yeah, so certifications really are beneficial to you only after you have experience. I'm in that mindset. Of course, it's not going to hurt to have it before, but it really matters if you have the experience. So yeah, I mean, if you're living abroad and want to come to America just to get into clinical research, I would caution you on that because it still takes a lot of hard work and effort to get a job in clinical research in America. Just because there might be more jobs to apply for does not mean you're going to necessarily get them, especially if you have to be sponsored and all that stuff. There are so many people in America already that they don't have to do that for to get, and they can give those jobs. I don't see necessarily why they would pick someone else if they had to sponsor them, unless you knew like multiple languages or you had some skill set that they really needed. I have seen jobs where, you know, if you're abroad, it's more likely than not that you know multiple languages. I have seen jobs where they do require someone who is fluent in a particular language, be it Spanish, be it Portuguese, be it French. I have seen that. So use that to your advantage if you're interested in coming to America and getting into clinical research. Use your language knowledge to your advantage, because they certainly will, and I think that will help you a lot in getting into certain positions faster. So that's one of the things I mentioned back to her when I emailed her back. But I think that about answers it. So basically, guys, you know, be careful with these certifications. There's a lot of them out there. There's a lot of websites out there, and I don't understand. I think there's like Barnett International. I'm saying that one correctly, but I've seen a few of them online, and I don't think they're that helpful. And to be honest with you, I'm not so sure that. I mean, the demand is so great for people with experience. Once you get a few years experience, I'm not so sure that you even need these certifications once you get experience. I know plenty of CRAs who do not have CCRP, but command multiple six-figure salaries or contracts or whatever it is. They make multiple six figures a year without these, just a bachelor's degree. So these certifications aren't necessarily, you know, what's needed. What you need is to get experience. And you can do that by getting in at entry level. You can do that by, trying to be a research assistant, trying to be an intern, trying to just help out a site in any way you can, be it patient recruitment, you know, any way you can get your experience. But there are universities that are offering programs, associate's degrees in clinical research. You can, you know, search, just do a quick Google search and see what they have to offer. And I think that'll be helpful for you. So comment down below if you have any questions. As always, email us eliteclinicalgroup@gmail.com for any questions you might have. We do have a phone number now, 910-502-3732. Call or text me there and you will get a response. All right, guys, take care.